place, which is Wake Forest Interdisciplinary Performance in the Liberal Arts Center. They are the people that are funding this, and that these performers are getting a stipend. I'm grateful to iPlace. I'm also grateful to the National Parkinson's Foundation. And today, what you're going to see basically is a real sort of glimpse into what our class looks like. And the good news is, you guys are going to do the warm up with us. So just join along.
My name is Nancy Grandoff, and I have been with Christina in her innovative dance class Wednesday mornings for 2 years.
Hello, I'm Rachel Kasky.
And I'm Rachel Bradley.
And we are Christina's student assistants with the Parkinson's class.
We let participants take a lot of independence. We're just there to kind of guide them.
And Superman flying, Superwoman flying. Good, and turn to the left.
My name is Connie Lopp. My husband is James Lopp, and we were actually involved with the first study that was done at Wake Forest about 4.5 years ago, and the second study that was done 2 years ago with Christina.
Enjoyed it. She comes up with positions and movements that you could never imagine.
My name is Mustafa Siddiqui. I am a movement disorder neurologist looking after the Parkinson's program at Wake Forest University. And this dance program, which is happening, has been so good for their both their emotional cognitive as well as their physical well-being, minimizing the fall risk.
We did with the presentation, and the audience was wonderful. They responded so good, and that just made us all, it made me feel good that so many people came to watch us. And I think today was very enjoyable, and I'm so glad Christina was able to see that.
This today has been just accumulation of many, many hours that she has dedicated.
Nancy, her dance with the painting, that was just almost brought tears to my eyes. She did a beautiful job.
And when she asked me to paint the ionic bench from the seating exhibit, the night of the preview, I happened to meet the owner of the exhibit, Diana Jacobson's. And she happened to tell me about a friend of hers that designed the bench. And her friend apparently has cancer. So it was a very emotional kind of thing to paint it to, under knowing those circumstances.
Briefly, Phil
author who will tell you a little bit about the exhibit and invite you to join.
We have times when we feel trapped in chairs in class or in meetings, and this shows that just because you're sitting doesn't mean you're resting and inactive. And the chairs in this exhibition through 200 years show that in chairs we can recline and we can spin and we can spring up and down and rotate in all kinds of directions, and designers want us to be comfortable as well as stylish.